bring your cushion under the lower back here. And connect your feet to the wall. Take the arms above your head, catch the elbows, and relax here for a moment. Lengthen both legs up. Just notice what's happening in the way you react to how you feel, in the way you breathe. Take your time. Bring the right ankle to the left thigh. Flex the feet, that means bring a 90 degree angle between feet and legs. Between the foot and the leg. Then slight bend in the left leg. Now you're going to interlace your fingers behind the left thigh, and with your right elbow, you're going to push the right thigh away from the right rib cage. I know it sounds complicated, so let's do it slowly. Interlace the fingers behind the left thigh. So you go through the leg behind the left thigh, and with the right elbow, you maintain a pressure against this left thigh, so it doesn't come to collapse against the rib cage. Keep it away from the ribs. And bend the left leg a little more. Press against the wall. And stay here. Notice how you feel in the right hip, in your back. Keep flexing the right foot. Keep awareness in the foot here. Keep the neck relaxed, the face relaxed. We're going to stay here for a while. So take your time. And when you feel that you feel comfortable where you are, bring the foot that's on the wall a little step down. And keep pushing the elbow in the right thigh for another few minutes, one or two. Keep the right foot flexed. Notice how you're breathing. How are you breathing? Are you using the belly? Use the belly. Inhale from the belly. Out through the rib cage. And breathe out to relax the spine down and bring the belly down towards the spine. Then if it's okay for you, lower the left foot against the wall a bit more. Deepen your breath, slowly and gently. Come out slowly. slowly out of the pose. Bring your butt a little bit closer to the wall. Right leg up and left ankle on the right thigh. So I don't know about you guys, but in my case, the left side is much tighter. So it deserves a bit more time in the pose. And if you're like me, then you will benefit also from giving the left hip joint, the left side, a bit more time to open and soften. Start maybe with the leg straight, left foot flexed, gently pressing with the left hand on the left thigh, not on the knee, but on the thigh, to push the thigh towards the wall. Let's start to soften into our breath. Gently press against the left thigh. Let's bend the right leg a little and interlace fingers behind the right thigh. Keep the left foot flexed and the left elbow is gently pushing the left thigh out. Stay here to soften the breath. Take a deep breath in, sigh out. And bend the right leg a bit more, lower the right foot against the wall, just a little. Feel the back of your left thigh, the left hip. If you have to relax the left arm, relax the left shoulder, do so. You don't have to be completely tense, pushing the left thigh all the time. It was just an option to bring more awareness in the opening of the left hip. Breathe. Take your time. Maybe here is the edge of your comfort zone. Is it? Keep monitoring the way you breathe. If you keep breathing slowly involving the belly, that means you are comfortable. If you are comfortable, maybe you can go a tiny bit deeper. If the breath is shallow and tight, maybe you went a bit too far. So back off a little. Come back to a breath that feels more comfortable. Explore, monitor, stay focused and relaxed. Keep the left foot flexed. If you can go a bit deeper, lower the right foot against the wall. Few more breaths, easy and slow. Press the lower back into the cushion, the right foot against the wall. Not too hard, just to notice the position of the body with more awareness. Ah. and come out slowly. Wrap your arms around the shin bones and gently press the knees down.